After the topics of limits, the more important topic is the differentiation, because economics relies much on the topics of differentiation, much of the skills of differentiation, especially to find the optimal value of X or Y. Well, we have lots of optimal value in economics we will come across, such as the utility and the cost of productions. Therefore, this should be the most important topics in the interviews questions. Here is a list of the rules of differentiation. First, assume C is a constant. If you differentiate the constant with respect to the variable, you got zero. And this is the power rule. You differentiate x to the power n with respect to x, you will put the power in front of the variables and minus 1 to be the new power. The third one is the constant times the functions. If you differentiate with respect to a constant times a function, you can take out the constant first, then do the differentiation with the function independently. The next one is called the sum rule. If you want to differentiate a function, which is fx plus gx, then you can just differentiate it with independently. For the power rule, product rule, if you want to differentiate with respect to fx times gx, you first differentiate the fx first, then times gx, then plus fx times the differentiate of the gx. Okay, and this is the quotient rule. You differentiate with respect to the numerator times the denominator minus the numerator times the differentiate of the denominator, then derived by the square of the denominators. And g is the chain rule. So y is a function of u is a function of x. Then if you are asked to calculate dy dx, this is equal to dy divided by dx, but you can derive by du first, then multiply by du again. Then you can do the chain rule like this. And finally, the log. You differentiate with respect to log x, it is equal to 1 derived by x. Okay, so you have lots of rules in the differentiation, such as the exponential function, but these are not that important in the economics, so you can skip this. But this field, you have to know how to calculate the derivatives. So here is an example, simple examples. You are asked to evaluate this. You differentiate this negative 7x to the power 11 divided by 8. So the way to do it is to apply the rule C, okay? You can take out the constant first. Here, the negative 7 divided by 8 is a constant. So you can take out it first. So this simplifies a lot. Then you can carry out the power rule. Take the 11, take the power to the front, times x, then raise the power 10. Okay. Then this is your solution. Negative 77 divided by x, 8 times x raised to the power 10. So this is the way to deal with the problem. Let's look at some more advanced examples. Polynomials. Okay. So the way to deal with the polynomial is to do the sum differentiate of each of them independently. Okay. So the first one, you take the power in the front, then this is equal to 3 times 2, which is equal to 6. W raised to the power 2. Okay. You minus the power by 1. Then plus. Okay, 9 here. You take the power in the front, it becomes 18 times W raised to the power 1, because it was raised to the power 2. Then minus 6. Okay. The fourth is the constant. Then you differentiate with respect to W will be equal to 0. So this is your final answer. So what is the meaning of differentiation? The differentiation means that there is a small changes in the value of the variables. So we are looking at the with small changes, what is the value of total changes? So how can it apply this information into economics? In economics, we have a jargon called marginal. So in the utility, you have the marginal utility. In the cost, you have marginal cost. So the way to deal with the, so how can the, how the economists use this differentiation with the marginal one? Marginal cost means that the changes in the total cost, if we include one more, if we produce one more output. Therefore, the marginal cost is the change in the cost, the DC, with respect to change in the output, DX, assume X is the output. Okay, so this is the way how the economists use differentiation in economics. For the average cost, this is just equal to the total cost divided by number of outputs. Okay, so if you are given a total cost equation, how you find the average cost? You just derive it by x, then you will get negative 0.02x plus 50 plus 100 divided by x. Many students make these mistakes, so they just ignore, neglect the 100 here, but make sure that you have to derive by x here. Okay, for the marginal cost, so you differentiate the cost function with respect to x, you get negative 0.01x plus 50. Okay, this is your marginal cost functions. So if you are asked to evaluate the average cost and marginal cost at various value of x, you just plug in the value of x into the AC function and MC function, then you get the result. For example, if you put x equal to 100, the average cost would just be 0.02, negative 0.02 times 100 plus 50 plus 100 divided by 100. Okay, and the result is 49. Marginal cost, again, plug in the x to be 100. Then you will get the marginal cost is 46. Then if the firm produce more, say this is more firm, just produce 100 output. Here, the firm produce 900. Then the average cost, you replace x by 900. What you will get is about 32, and marginal cost, again, use the marginal cost function, you replay x by 900 plus 50, you get 14. Okay, so this is the way to calculate the marginal cost and average cost mechanically. However, if you are asked to provide some intuitions, what is the implication of this cost function? Well, you can see that the average cost is lowered if the firm produces more. This is the concept of economies of scale. Okay, but is this marginal cost function good or bad? Well, in my opinion, this is not a very good cost function, because if you have some sense of economics, you know the law of diminishing marginal returns. You know that the marginal cost will eventually increase if the output increases. But here you can see that the marginal cost is always decreasing, it won't increase. So this cost equation failed to capture this information. Okay, so this is the way how the economists use differentiation in economics. Next, let's go back to the basic mathematics, focusing on the ECOF major selection interviews. Okay, one of the most frequently asked question is to sketch the function, graph sketching. It is not easy because you have to make sure you know when will the function be increasing, when will the function be decreasing, and where they change the sign. Okay, and in this sense, you have to know how to make use of the derivatives, because what derivatives tell us is the change. Okay, the change in the value. So here, for example, if you look at these functions, so this function is always increasing, okay? But how can we represent it in the differentiations? So we can represent this as the f prime bigger than 0. That means if we differentiate this function with respect to x, this is positive. This is because if we take x here, we can see the slope is like this. And if we take the point x here, which is bigger than before, increasing x, okay, we can find that the slope is steeper, okay. It shows that the function f is increasing, okay. But all in all, the slope is increasing means that they are increasing, okay. Well, first ignore what I mentioned, that the slope is steeper, okay. What you need to know now is if f prime is bigger than 0, this is an increasing function. Similarly here, you can see that if you differentiate this point, you will find a negative least slope. If you differentiate this point, you find a negative slope, okay. So this means the f prime is less than 0. So if you want to see whether the function is increasing or decreasing, the first thing you need to see is that whether the first derivative is positive or negative. For example, you may be given this kind of information and you are asked to draw the functions. So for example, here you can see that the first derivative is positive at the domain negative infinity to 0, from 4 to 6, and from 6 to infinity. And this is decreasing in 4 to 6. Okay, so based on the first two, you can already deduce some behavior, okay. So this is negative infinity, this is infinity. From negative infinity to 0, okay, the f prime is bigger than 0, that means this is increasing. And from 0 to 4, the f prime is less than 0, that means this is decreasing, okay. From 4 to 6, this is increasing. From 6 to infinity, this is also increasing, okay. So this is what we can conclude in the first two. For the third one, f prime 0 is undefined. So undefined means that the slope is infinity, okay. That means this is vertical. Therefore, you know that at point 0, this is undefined, okay. The slope is vertical, or there is a sudden change in the sign, okay. And f prime 4 and f prime 6 is equal to 0. So the first derivative stands for the slope. The slope equal to 0 means that they are either at the maximum, minimum, or in the inflection point, okay. But how can we ensure that whether this is the maximum point, minimum point, or inflection point? You have to look at the places before or after, okay. So here at 4, okay, here 4, you can see that it decreased before reaching the 4 and increased after they reach the 4. So therefore you know that this must be the minimum point. While at the value 6, you see that before 6 this is increasing, and after 6 this is also increasing. That means at 6 this is the inflection point. So if you draw the function, okay, this will be something like, before that this is increasing, and at 0 this suddenly drop, okay. Then at the 4 this reached the minimum, and 6 this is a flat place, then increase at the end, okay. So this is 0, 4, 6, okay. So So this is the skills for you to sketch the graph. Okay. How about if you are just given a function and you are asked to sketch the graph? For example, you are given this function 2x to the power 3 plus 3x squared plus 1. The first thing you need to do is to find the critical points. Okay, that means you are going to find the f prime of x equal to 0. Because in this sense, you can find whether where this changed the sign or whether this is flat or not. Okay. So the first step, find the critical point. Do the first derivative test. This is equal to 6x squared plus 6x equal to 0. Okay. Then this is equal to 6x times x plus 1. Okay. Then you can see the critical point of x, it can be negative 1 or it is equal to 0, because only in these two regions, these two points, the left hand side to the right hand side. Okay. Then you can separate in the three part before negative 1, between negative 1 and 0, and after 0. Okay. So before negative 1, between negative 1 and 0, and after 0. Okay. So to see whether this is the maximum or minimum, you have to compare. So at the region below the negative 1, say you can take the value of negative 2, okay? Then you can substitute the slope of negative 2 to see whether this is increasing or decreasing. You know that when x is equal to negative 1, this is equal to 0. So you put f prime negative 2, what you will get is 12, okay? Plug in the value of negative 2 here. So you can see that before the negative 1, this is positive value. That means before negative 1, this is increasing. Next, between negative 1 and 0, say you can take negative 1 half, okay? Then you calculate, it will become negative 3 over 2, which is negative. That means you know that at this region, negative 1 and 0, this is decreasing. And you can conclude that at x equal to negative 1, this is the maximum, okay? Then after x equal to 0, say you can take f prime 1, okay, this is after 0, then you get the value is equal to 12, which is positive. This means they increase again. Therefore, you can conclude that at x equal to 0, this is the minimum point. This is the maximum point. Okay, so if you want to draw it, this is something like, okay, so this is the value when x equal to negative 1, this is the value of when x equal to 0. Okay, so in conclusion, if you want to find the minimum, you are going to find that whether the f prime x equal to 0. Before that, the f prime x is negative. After that, the f prime x is positive. If you want to find the maximum point, first locate a critical point f prime x equal to 0. And you look at the before that, f prime is bigger than 0, and after that, f prime is less than 0. Then this is the way how you find the critical points.